Hello and welcome. Most of you might know this. After a mailback video from some YouTuber, you bought a bunch of these super cheap DC-DC modules from China, but you have no idea if they are any good. Will they burn your house down? Are they going to release the magic smoke on the first use? And how efficient are they? But testing the efficiency couldn't be easier. You just need 4 multimeters, a power supply, some kind of load like a resistor, and about 100 measuring cables to connect all of that. Just apply voltage to the module, connect the load, measure the voltage and the current on the inputs and outputs, write all of that down, calculate the input and the output power, and then calculate the efficiency. Simply do this with several input voltages and load currents, and you get all the data to create efficiency graphs. But doing that manually takes forever and is pretty annoying. For modules with adjustable output voltage, it's even worse, because you need to repeat all of this for every output voltage. But no worries, we can let the computer do the work, and that's what I built this automatic test setup for. Because I want to do these measurements in a semi-automatic fashion, the power supply and the load need to be remote controlled. I will use my Korat power supply and my iTech DC load. Both can be remote controlled via USB, and there is a LabVIEW driver available. For all the measurements, I use my Keithley 2700 RON 6.5 digit multimeter. Mine has 2 MUX modules with a total of 60 channels installed. MUX modules are boxes full of relays that allow to switch the multimeter input between all the channels. I won't need that many channels, but I'll use 4 of them to do all the required measurements. The schematic of the complete setup looks like this. Because my MUX cards can only switch channels for voltage measurement, I need shunt resistors for the current measurement on the input and the output of the DC-DC. I want to measure the input and output voltages as close to the pads of the tested module as possible. That's why I need to connect 2 cables to each pad, one to carry the current and one to tap off the voltage. This is already version 2 of the test setup. Version 1 used a DC load that I developed myself. Unfortunately, it is designed for lower power and thus already claimed some sacrifice for overloading it. The DC load in the new version can dissipate up to 150 watt, so there won't be any issue with bigger converters. All the wiring is done on the bottom side of the PCB, so the top side looks pretty nice and clean. On the left side of the PCB you can see the connector for the multimeter. I broke out all the channels of the MUX cards in groups of 4 channels to this 9-pin sub-D connectors. This way I can plug the cable from the multimeter directly into the test adapter. You can also see the 2 shunt resistors of the current measurements. I measured the value of these very precisely using several known current values and the Keithley multimeter to measure the dropped voltage. The power supply and the DC load are connected via 4mm banana plugs. The device under test is connected via this removable screw terminals. So much for the hardware, now to the software. I use LabVIEW 2014 SP1 in the home and student edition. You can get this for about 50 bucks as long as you don't use it commercially. I designed this crude graphical user interface to adjust the most important parameters. On the left side, the input voltage parameters can be set. The test will go through this voltage range in the adjusted increments. For every input voltage, the output current should be tested in the configured range. The parameters in the middle are settings for this. On the right side, some parameters for the multimeter can be adjusted, mainly which channels are connected to what. The values of the shunt resistors also need to be configured, so the script can convert the measurements directly into the correct current values. All the results will be stored in a CSV file. Now to the block diagram. Apart from the initialization, the program consists of two loops, one outer loop for the source voltage and one inner loop for the load current. The outer loop will set a voltage, then run the inner loop to test all the required currents. The measurement results are collected from the multimeter and are written to a new CSV file after the inner loop finished. This way I get a separate file for every tested input voltage. The outer loop increases the input voltage and starts the process again, until it has completed the configured range. That's all that is to this program. Pretty simple. Unfortunately, the block diagram doesn't look that simple. Graphical programming is fine for simple tasks, but as you can see on my relatively simple project, it gets messy pretty fast. Things that would take one line of C code can take up a large portion of the screen and are hard to follow if there are more than a few mathematical operators. If else, decisions require the use of case structures. These show only one of the possible choices on the screen. The other choices are hidden and you have to click through them to see what's going on. If you want to use subfunctions, you need to rely on the symbol that was chosen to tell them apart. The iTech driver uses the same symbol for all of its functions, so that's not helping much for readability. But the most annoying thing about the block diagram is that there's no way to zoom the view. With a high resolution monitor, the symbols get already pretty small, so don't even think about getting a 4K monitor. I chose to use LabVIEW because there are drivers available for all the used instruments. But most of the drivers had little or no documentation with them. Also, examples how to use them are not always included. During the development, I got the feeling that many of the LabVIEW drivers are pretty sketchy and badly maintained, if at all. So I had to adapt the driver for the power supply because it was looking for the wrong device ID. The driver for the DC load is very unreliable. Getting it to connect to the device sometimes requires several restarts of the load. If I used the driver to read the current and the voltage from the device, it frequently locks up, so I can't use that function. The LabVIEW driver is only a wrapper for a DLL anyway, so there's no way to fix such issues myself. The only driver that worked well out of the box is the driver for the Keesley multimeter. But enough with the ranting, I got it to work decently after all. Let's see it in action. I have set this MP2307 based module to 5V output voltage. The input voltage range is set from 6V to 22V in 2V increments. The current range will start with 10mA, increment by 10mA until 100mA, and then increment by 100mA until 1.8A. As you can imagine, this will take a while to run, but compared to doing it manually, it is done in no time at all. I will cut this short, because there is not very much to see for the video. Through the magic of video editing, the results are already in. To create the diagrams we all want to see, I made a little Excel macro. So I just need to select the source files I want and it imports all the data. The diagram looks like this. While I was at it, I also added a diagram with the output voltage. I now can use these diagrams to make an overview data sheet for the module I tested. Also, I add some further information about the module, like the specs, a few pictures, and the schematic, if I can figure that out with reasonable effort. The result of all this effort looks like this. In case you are interested in downloading this or other data sheets I created, you can do that on my homepage. You can find the link in the video description. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, leave me a like and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this in the future.